Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I thought I would do a video today about a bag that I've been planning to do a video on for months now, and I actually think it's been about a year, which is ridiculous because I haven't used the bag yet as I haven't done a video. So I've literally had this bag sitting on my shelf in its dust bag, being neglected just because I haven't done a video, and that is really, really sad. So I thought it was high time I actually got my bum in gear and sat down and filmed this. So that's what I'm doing today. The bag that I'm talking about is a bag from Chloe, and I actually bought this bag pre-loved from one of the Facebook groups that I'm in. I do like buying bags from the groups because I find that you can get some really, really good deals on there. A lot of the ladies in the groups and the guys as well, you kind of get to know them and they become, you know, friends almost, like, you know, your little online friend group, and you all share the same interests. So it's nice because we've got the handbag sales pages, and then we've got the handbag chat groups, and we've all kind of met through that, and it's really nice. I actually run one of the handbag chat groups called the Authentic Handbag Chat Group UK. Bit of a mouthful, but that's what it's called. And we've got loads of ladies in there from the UK, but also all over the world, and we just talk about handbags all day. So if you want to come and join us, we'd love to have you. But as I said, I got this bag from one of the other pages because we don't have sales on the page that I run. It's just for chat. So this was from a different group. It was from a really well-known seller, so I had no worries about the authenticity at all. So I'm going to stop waffling now and I'm going to show you the bag. So it only came with a dust bag. Most Chloe bags don't actually come with boxes unless you... I think you can get a box if you request one when you buy a bag sometimes, or possibly when you buy online, but I know a lot of the bags do not come with boxes. So the dust bag is like a really thick cotton, and it does say Chloe on the front there, but it's really in a light colour, so it's a little bit hard to see. But also, I did actually break the drawstring on this. That was me. They did not come like that. I was a little bit over aggressive when I was trying to close it one day and ripped it. But inside the bag I have is the Chloe Faye backpack in the size small, which is the larger of the two. There's this size and there's a mini as well. As you can see, the bag is still new with tags. Like, the lady that I bought it off had never used it, and I never used it, so it is still brand new. So this bag, I originally wanted the Chloe Faye cross, you know, like the shoulder bag, the, you know, just the regular handbag one, but I saw this one come up on the sales page, and it was such a good price that I thought I could get the same look with this bag as I could with the regular Faye handbag, but it was kind of a little bit more versatile because this bag comes with a shoulder strap, so you can wear it just over your shoulder, and it also has detachable backpack straps as well, which are adjustable, removable, fiddly, but that's what they look like there. The bag is made from, it is black grained calfskin leather here, and then the flap here is made from suede, calfskin suede. And I'll show you the inside.
Oh,
And then the inside is lined in like a beige canvas material. So the main feature of the Chloe Faye bags is this big loop thing, and the chain here as well. So this is how you open the bag. You hold the loop and there is a really strong magnet under there, and then that opens like that. The chain here is not removable, so you can take it off here. Bit fiddly. Well, I think the idea is that you can take that part off. Maybe, let me see if I can get that off. Okay, so although that is actually a hook that would be removable, the gap there is not actually big enough to get this thick hoop out of. So I would say it's meant to be removable, but it's not actually physically removable. But that doesn't bother me, because as I said, this is the main feature of this bag, and I think that's what makes it stand out. So why would I want to remove it? The only thing is, it is a little bit fiddly. So as I said, this has got the really strong magnet, and then once you do, it just shuts itself as well. You have to kind of contend with the chain here when opening and closing the bag. But I do like this strong magnet, because when you shut it, it shuts itself. So that's a good feature of the bag. On the front here, it says Chloe, kind of stamped into the suede there. And this is gorgeous suede. So when you brush it one way, it kind of gets finger marks in it a little bit. But it's really nice. The leather is absolutely beautiful. They call this grained leather, so it's kind of pebbled leather. But I read on the website that apparently it's sanded. The surface of the leather is sanded to give it like a velvet type finish. So I must admit, it is really, really soft, thick leather. It, probably out of all my bags, this has got one of the thickest, most substantial leathers on it that I've felt on, you know, on my bags. So there's the bottom of the bag. As you can see, it is quite a large bag, got quite a big capacity. There is the, remove that, side profile. And the other side. And the back of the bag. These straps here are completely removable. They have these hooks here with a leather tab just for added security, so you can actually move that leather so it opens and closes like that. And then if you pop that leather up over that, it just stops that opening. They are adjustable as well. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 holes on each strap, so really adjustable. On the label here, it just says Chloe on the front there, and then it says, I'll just let you have a quick look. There's nothing extremely interesting on there, and it's just code numbers. And also this shoulder strap, which is nice and thin, very comfortable to wear on your shoulder, that is removable as well with the hooks. They also have the leather tab on them. So now I'm going to show you the inside of the bag a little bit more closely. So another main feature of this bag are these two zips here on the side. So these can actually be opened up like that to increase the size of the opening. And as you can see, you've got a really large capacity there for all your bits and bobs. You can fit loads in there. You can even fit a bottle of water standing up in that, no problem. And inside there is a zipped pocket there. And Chloe made in Italy leather tab. See anything on it? Nothing on the back of the tab. Inside the pocket, I have this little envelope with care instructions and the authenticity card. And then in the front of the bag, so on the front section, there is a slip pocket there as well, big enough for your phone. So I actually really like the look of this bag with the zips open, because there is suede on the inside of the, like, the gussets here. So I like the different textures that that brings to the bag, especially when it's shut like that. When you've got your stuff in, obviously these stay open a bit more. I think it looks really edgy and cool. So the cost of this bag full price is £1,290. As I said, I got this bag pre-loved, and I only paid £600 for it. So if you know where to look and you know, keep an eye out, you will find people that are selling these for such a great deal. I mean, £600 for a bag like this is a bargain. It comes in three colours at the moment that I could see on the Chloe website. I do believe they do seasonal colours as well, but this is the black. It also comes in a colour called tan, which is the one that's like a burnt orange colour. And then there is also one called Motte Grey, which is the kind of grey toned beigey colour. The chain and the ring on the front here are actually gold. It's like a champagne gold, and the hook is silver. So it incorporates both gold and silver tones into a bag. So you can wear it with either gold or silver, and it's going to complement your outfit, whatever you're wearing, and your jewellery as well. So I know some people are a bit like, oh, I like it to be all gold or all silver. But again, I kind of like the different materials that they've used. So you've got the gold and the silver, and then you've got the suede and the leather. And I think it just adds something extra to the bag, makes it more unusual. Dimensions of the bag are, it is 23 centimeters from top to bottom. The width is 20 centimeters and the depth is 14 centimeters. And I'll just quickly show you what I've got in the bag at the moment. As I said, it is quite heavy. I don't think my other bags feel this heavy with my stuff in, so maybe I just hadn't noticed that the bag is, I think because it's a thicker leather, it is more hefty. So if you're not very comfortable wearing heavier bags, this might not be the bag for you. But inside there, I really have got all of my, like, daily essentials, and as you can see, they're all sitting in the bottom with, like, half the bag with more room for extra things. So even though it doesn't look very big just to look at, you can fit loads in here. So I have got my phone, my mini pochette, my cosmetic case in smaller size, power bank, and my round zippy coin purse. So as I said, those are my essentials, and that just fits in the bottom of the bag. There's plenty of room in there for sunglasses, or if it was cold, maybe a shawl, a bottle of water, your keys. You could fit everything in there, I reckon, that you'd need on a day out. I did just want to say that the only thing that I'm not thrilled to bits with this bag is how, when you've got it on your back, it kind of tilts backwards. Like, there's quite a big gap
between my back and the back of the bag there. I've tried tightening the straps. I mean, if I have it really tight, it will sit flush against my back like that. But then I also can't get my arms out of the straps. And if I have it any looser, I'll just show you. So this is the bag on the loosest setting. And as you can see, it does allow the bag to tilt back even further. So I do worry that if the bag is on a looser strap, that the weight of your contents inside the bag could actually lift the flap open, and you could lose things, or people could possibly get their hand in there. You know, it is something that you would have to watch. So obviously if you have the straps tighter, it does bring it closer to your body. I've put that back on the middle hole, the fourth hole, and I think, you know, with the adjustments, you know, bearing in mind your shape and size, you can make this bag work for you. I'm quite comfortable with the bag being like that. I think that looks all right. And then the last thing I wanted to show you was the bag on one shoulder. As you can see, not ideal, because it really does tilt back quite a long way. If you have rounded shoulders like me, it's actually quite hard to keep on your shoulder as well. It doesn't want to stay there, it keeps falling off. I think if you're going to wear it on one shoulder, just use the shoulder strap, because I think by far, for me, that looks best.
I did think it was probably worth mentioning, I've just tried to remove the backpack straps from this bag, and it is not easy. So this part is absolutely fine, you just unclip that. But when it comes to this part, you have to take the little popper out of the hole. So move the loops back a bit, unpop that, then you have to get this popper through these loops. And the only way to do it is to pull it hard, because you're having to get something with a massive knobble on it through something with no gap. So the only way that I could do it was to pull it hard, which is then kind of stretching the stitches there. But, and it is not easy. My God. Surely there's an easier way to do this. God, I'm really worried that if I pull this through, I'm never going to be able to get it back. Like, how is that removable? I mean, I managed one, but it wasn't easy. This one's being much, much stiffer. Oh, right, I got it through one. Now I've got to get it through the other one. Oh my God, if you had, like, problems with your hands, there's no way you'd be able to do this. Alright, I did it. Okay. But, like, surely that stretches these loops out. Crazy. So this is what the bag looks like without the straps on the back. Just as a little shoulder bag. I'm going to try it like this, because I think I prefer it this way than with the straps, which seems ridiculous for a backpack. Like, my brain's like, it's a backpack, why are you taking the straps off? And I think that's just about it, really. So, if you do have any questions regarding this bag, please do feel free to leave a comment below and I will see if I can help you. And now I'm actually going to use this little beauty and give her some of the attention that she clearly deserves. So I hope you enjoyed that. and I shall see you in the next video. Bye.